I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no hoe. I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling all my bros. Ain't no killer, but don't push me, fingers itching on that pole. Niggas.
Truth is, I'm tired. Options are few. I'm trying to pray, but where are you?
Yeah. Offense got to have the worst luck when it come to offensive linemen. What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, K-Flex. I'm back here with another video, and this is a video I do not want to have to make. Josh Sitton placed on IR. He's out for the season, okay? Our all-pro, Pro Bowl lineman out for the season with a rotator cuff that he played through game one, but I couldn't play for the rest of the season. I'm not going to question his toughness, okay? You can't play. But I will say this. Oh, my God. Miami Dolphins have the worst luck, and this is kind of a thing what happens. I'm not going to get too mad. It's injuries, part of football. It's what happened to every team. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not mad that he's injured. I kind of f***ing am. I don't go lie. But, you know, I understand he's injured. It's going to happen to every team. Delanie Walker just got injured for a season playing against the Miami Dolphins. That's something the Titans are going to have to deal with and overcome. We just going to have to deal with this and overcome it. I'm sure there's other injuries around the league that I don't really like to think about because but listen, Miami Dolphins cannot catch a break on these offensive lineman. Now I'll tell you one thing. Look at Josh Sitton's career. Now Brandon Albert is different. Brandon Albert had only played one full season before he even came to the Dolphins. I'm gonna talk about some free agent linemen that Miami Dolphins got. You look at the last Pro Bowl lineman we got with Brandon Albert out of free agency, I'm pretty sure. And Brandon Albert was already injury prone before he came to our team. He had only played one full season in his whole career before he came to Miami Dolphins. He only was able to play all 16 games. So when he came to the Miami Dolphins and he was injury prone, it was kind of like, oh, this is what he is. Okay, he was a Pro Bowl lineman. You look at Mike Pouncey, another Pro Bowl lineman, could barely finish a season. After his first two seasons, he played all 16 games, never played all 16 games ever since his first two seasons.
I take that back, fact check real quick. He actually did play all 16 games last season, okay? But that was the only other season we actually played all 16 games besides his first two seasons. All right, continue.
He was injury prone. Then you go to Ted Larson even, who's going to be replacing Josh Sitton this year. Last season, Ted Larson had only missed games in one season. It was just like, it was one season he played 10 games, but every other season he played the whole season except for his rookie year. Ted Larson was a guy who was hardly ever injured. Then last year, turns around, tears his bicep, ends up missing 8 games half the season, okay?
Bruh.
I'm saying, like, we got and now we go to Josh Sitton. Josh Sitton is a guy who literally, since his rookie year, I don't know if he was really starting the whole time of the rookie year, but right after his rookie year, he never missed a f***ing game. I feel like really, like, Super Bowl kind of take luck now. I really feel that way because you gotta, like, not only do you have to be the best team, you have to be a better team every game. You gotta not get cheated by the refs, and you gotta pray that nobody big on your team gets injured. This shit is bullshit. But anyways, listen. Yeah, he missed 2 games. He missed 2 games, okay? In 7 years, he missed 2 games. Keep that in mind. Now, you fast forward him going to the Bears. With the Bears, he missed a total of 6 games in 2 seasons. Last year and the year before he played for the Bears, he missed a total of 6 games, okay? 3 in each season, right? So total in his career, he missed about 8 games, okay? 6 of them came in the last 2 seasons. Now he's going to miss 15 this season. Do you understand how unlucky that is? He's going to miss more games this season than he's missed his whole 11-year career or 12-year career. You know what I'm saying? And maybe it's a sign of him getting old because he never got hurt with the Packers and all of a sudden he's hurt with the Bears only for 3 games, though. And see, me personally, I'm thinking, okay, if he's hurt, he'll be better than 3 games maximum because he's only missed 3 games before, so I don't expect it to be a season-ending injury, but it is. And it's just terrible. Not to mention, I have to deal with a lot of injuries. The Falcons lost Keanu O'Neal, and they lost Deion Jones. So, like I said, guys, good teams got to deal with injuries. It's just the way it is. But Miami Dolphins, I feel like I cursed in the fact that every O-line we get is straight injury. It's just injury prone. It's just, it don't make no sense. And, you know, like I said, it could come with age, and that's a problem with signing these older people. You're trying Josh Sitton, these people that's over 30, you know, these people are more likely to get injured. It's just a fact that, you know, older players are more likely to get injured. So, Josh Sitton is a guy who, you know, got injured, and it don't look like he would. Like, look at his face, y'all. He look like a damn Viking, y'all. He look like it's the toughest of mother in the world. He's like a, and he's huge. He's like the toughest of mother in the world. And you know, you just don't expect him to just not be able to play with something, but, you know, it's a serious injury. F*** it, you know. I don't know, man. Ted Larson's going to have to step in his spot. And Ted Larson is a guy who has been in the league for over a decade. And, he can play. You don't make it, you know, you don't last as long in the league if you can't play. So, he can play for sure. Is it going to be Johnson? No. But can he at least be, you know, I don't know. You know, the offensive line is oftentimes, it's just like how they work together. So, if they can work together for him, it'd be fine. I'm pretty sure Johnson was the type of guy who could make up for others' mistakes. I don't know if Ted Larson is that kind of guy. Probably not. Also, Johnson could really block out people out the hole. But, you know, you can't be mad at nobody. It's part of football. You cannot be mad at nobody. I can't even be mad at Johnson. I can't be mad. It's not his fault he got hurt. I can't be mad at anybody. You know what I'm saying? I like the signing. And, you know, even though he was older, when we pick up a player, I don't really think about injuries, you know. And this dude wasn't injury prone at all. And he's over the last two seasons, he's gotten minor injuries. We missed a couple games. And now all of a sudden, he gets a major injury for the first time in his career when he signs with the Miami Dolphins out of all teams, because that's what happens. Moving on from this, we just gotta see how Ted Larson. I'm gonna be paying attention to Ted Larson against the Jets. We just gonna have to see how it works out. Hopefully, it's not too much of a difference. Like I said, Ted Larson is not no bum coming off the bench. He's not Eric Flowers. He's not damn Chaz Green. Who remembers that game last year with the Cowboys? That Chaz, like, he's not like that. Been in the league for 10 years. Solid backup. You know what I'm saying? And we'll see what happens. Let me know what you guys think about this. Obviously, you guys, you know, I wouldn't panic too much, okay? Season's not over. 1-0 at the end of the day. See what the f*** happened with that. And then we're going to reanalyze. See what happened with our offensive line this coming up week. It's your boy, K Flexin. I'm out.
For the crystal many times, but I knew this moment to come. Now it's my time. I gotta make up for all them nights that my mama cried. I'm going in, I'm putting.